I think that the president hit on the all right tones in his speech today. His speech was conciliatory, it was outreaching, it was upbeat, and I think he will gain a lot of credibility in the Arab world and the Muslim world because of that speech.
He called on democracies to be more than just the image of a democracy, to really allow oppositions to organize politically. And here, he may have been, in a diplomatic way, critical of Egypt.
I don't think so. I think the president met today with President Mubarak, and I think that the main message was that we work together. We work together on all aspects, whether it's political reform or it's economic reform, or, of course, issues in the region. And I think this kind of spirit is different when you try to impose something on other countries. And I think in his message it was very clear that he doesn't want to impose anything, that the U.S. should not impose, should not assume that she knows better about issues like this. He did not compromise his own values, but at the end, it's advice rather than any other thing.
At the same time, there are many people in Egypt that are listening to this speech that heard it today. They heard a call, a real call there, for your government to open up more, the political process, to ease the pressure on the opposition. How does President Mubarak see this? How do you see it, Mr. Prime Minister?
Well, we clearly say that Egypt has been on a path of political reform for some time now, and I believe that we have taken very positive steps. I think they've been undermined a little bit in the media, but at the end of the day, I believe that Egypt today, if compared to any other country in the region, has taken real steps in terms of its political reform. If you look at the freedom of speech, the freedom of presenting your ideas, it is there today. We now have a different electoral and presidential election systems in Egypt. We still need to go some more ways, but I think that the message is we have to do it in our own way and we have to do it in our own pace.
All right, let's look at that broader view. There have been people that listened to this speech and said it was great what we heard, and we were glad to hear the U.S. president say this. Now we need the deeds to back it up. What would you say the U.S. has to do?
I would say what the president has done was necessary but not sufficient in many ways. I mean, you needed to come back and say clearly that the U.S. stands in a fair way and it looks at the Muslim world in a fair way. And I think some of the statements were very important. The fact that the president has even quoted the Quran in some of his in part of his speech, I think, was well received. It shows that he has deep understanding of this part of the world. And at the end, it is actions that count, of course, but I think that this is a very, very good first step. It needs, of course, to be followed by actual actions, and I think that the president had in his speech some of those actions in mind when he spoke about the stopping the settlements, for example, by the Israelis, when he talked about the two-state solution. These are all, I think, welcomed statements, but at the end they are statements and they need to be followed by actual actions by the United States.